Hokies won that kicking contest. Hokies won the kicking contest. I'd like to give a super shout out to some of our sponsors. Earth Fair, the healthy supermarket, the Flats in Mallard Creek, Body Bye Bye Challenge, Abilene Sports Medicine and Orthopedics, the Greater Akron Chamber, Domino's Pizza, and Akron University. Back to the action now. And the Diamond Deli, best corned beef in Akron. For sure. Can't forget that. Extracurricular activity.
Second down and about six.
There after the short run by Dominic Morris. Run up the middle by Dominic Morris. Brought down play by number four, Carlos Ware.
Third and about three.
After a game of Nick Elko, or excuse me, Dick Mullen in there, quarterback for the offense. Carlos Ware making another play there. Moves to the other side of the formation. Based off the coach here, and they have found that in the right spot. We have another fumbled snap there. The
about four.
Oh, excuse me, sorry about that, folks. I was adjusting my punch. Kordakis comes across the formation. Mullen takes a snap from center in the shotgun. Throws over to David Pavelic, low pass. Pavelic scoops it off the turf. Puts his head down before he gets tackled. And that first turn of the
game goes to Chris Mullen. Over his Hokies knee. Cardinals over his Hokies knee.
Number 71, the defensive lineman, Caesar Burton, is making his way over the way to clean up the pot.
Yeah, the first half.
Cornerback. Made a few plays so far today. Looks like John Lobb under center. Pitch out to CJ Tuck to the right side. Gets a good block from John Kirk. That's a good block. Makes a man miss. Gets tackled by Tony Tatum there. Met at the 45 yard line, where he is met by Tony Tatum and taken down. A good looking run.
First down.
A big problem here for CJ Tuckett. We know some of you are following along with us on live stream. Thank you for tuning in. We thank all of you that are watching at home for tuning in with us today. John Lobb under center. John Frick shoots out off to the right. Give Mr. Tuckett one more time. Bounces it to the right. Tries to come back to the left, but he's stopped there by the defensive line. Javon Jordan there helping to clean up the pile. Number 75. Rodman Baltimore also in there. Joe Narcisse gets up off the pile as well. Looks like we're going to have a penalty. We have a false start penalty against the offense. So that'll back them up. Repping on the bench press. LaVon McCoy from Bethune-Cookman, 36 reps. Lance Castleman, Arizona, 31 reps. CJ Carroll with 30 reps. Zach Van Dusen, 29, and Gus Toka with 26. Looks like Ben Peacher may have gotten offside there. He got a good jump. CJ Tuckett carried John Lobb in there at corner, quarterback for the offense. John Frick playing fullback. Low snap, fumble on the play. Lobb just lets that one roll in the turf as the defensive line then swarms in there. Recovered by the defense.
Turnover. Hokie's ball. Hokie's ball. Hokie's ball. Hokie's ball. Hokie's ball.
Challenge down here, guys. Enjoy the pizza. Enjoy the pizza. For all you back home, why don't you order a pizza right now and have it while you're watching the broadcast? As you see, that looked like Dominic Warner, excuse me, though, that was Marcus Griffin getting swallowed up there by number 72, Leonidas Redding from West Liberty. He just busted through the offensive line. Another great play by a defensive line. You guys are chilling right now. Challenge down and join the pizza. So, a great play there by Leonidas Reddit. You guys can just nod if you agree. They agree, ladies and gentlemen. Well, thank you guys. But let's give a shout out to Vanessa, the camera girl here from
Additional
Campbell
points
University. She may have one of the to do.
At halftime.
No pizza for Vanessa? Already asked her. Well, Vanessa, you just watched this place. I think grab that when he gets a chance. But thanks to Vanessa and Justin Pekoski, our statistician, expert statistician, for giving stats compiled for us today. Nick Elko in there, quarterback. False start called on the play. Just another false start on the offense, and you know, kind of goes back to the snap couch being different.
Yeah.
Marcus Griffin on the fake goes down through the arms of number 83, Justin Hem, after the fake to Marcus Griffin. Had me out there for Marcus Griffin carrying the ball on the right side, but it was Nick Elko with the solid play fake there. And talk about how important is it for a quarterback to be a master of the play fake?
Yeah, it's a big thing.
Give is to Marcus Griffin, or excuse me, that is Dominic Morris up the middle. Jameson Manuma already has pick six in today's game. The linebacker picked off the pass early on in the game. The game Bulls opening score?
Could be.
We've had, three guys return? We've had four interceptions, three of them were returned for touchdowns by this defense. It was. I completely agree with you on that one. Rehydrated. Water is a great thing. Especially for these players down there on the field. Needing a little bit of water. So to the broadcast, we need a little bit of water. As you may be hearing, or may not be hearing if you've got it muted. Why would you do that? Nick Elko dumps it down short to Justin Allen. But the pass gets separated from the ball immediately by a solid hit from number 24, Dwayne Hollis, who also All-American.
Athletes, you're not allowed to participate in the game. We're not participating earlier. There is lunch at the far end.
Watch out, LeBron.
Change now, actually a personnel change for both the offense and the defense. Justin Sotelaire now in there for the defense, or for the offense, excuse me, playing quarterback. The give is to Dominic Morris off the right side, gets a block from David Pavelic. Gets upfield, a good solid open field tackle as it was number 25. Mike McMillan came up to make the stop there. Solid open field tackle, how important is the quarterback? Justin Sotelaire in at quarterback, Theron Allen Jr. in the backfield. Pavelic motions across the line of scrimmage. The give is to Allen, off to the right side, or left side, excuse me. Tries to go for a stiff arm, but he is wrestled down by number 51, Jamel Wilmore, out of Western Illinois. Jeffrey University product, A.J. Parrish. Flag down on the play. Get that for you. Take a look at the vertical dump numbers. Jeff Simmons from Emporia State had the highest with 42 inches. Rashad Rich, wide receiver from Macomb, 41 inches. Daryl Hamilton with 39.5 inch jump. Mike McMillan, you saw him make a play, 39 inch vertical. And Manel Elmore, the wide receiver from South Carolina State, the 38.5 inch vertical. What is the importance of the vertical? What are the scouts looking for when the vertical is? About 13 down inside the 20 yard, down inside the 25 yard line, excuse me, where the offense will take over with a first down and 10. So starting to get a little bit of momentum with the running game. Looking for Chris Kordakis, he throws it to the back corner of the end zone. Kordakis looks, and it's going to be intercepted by number 21. A great intercept by Chris Muhammad, So the fifth interception out for this defense, Chuck Kordakis tried to break him up with a big
ball hit,
but it was not meant to be, as the fifth interception in the end zone, though that's by Chris Muhammad. The fifth interception. And to hang on from the ball to the back of the lady.
Yeah, absolutely.
Quarterback change now as Jake Mullen is in there, fumbles the snap, and it is going to be recovered by number 97, Gus Koka, off the edge. Another guy has a pretty good day defensively. Turnover, but not really, as it'll stay with the offense, but it'll go down as listed as a fumble recovery. Gus Koka. Not your average all-star game, but it's fair and it came to everybody. Fair record. DJ Tuckett had some room to run there, but then Joe Narcisse came through and fourth score. Been flying around. Now, guys, I will have to break it from because I can't let this last one. So I'm gonna have to put it out of the misery and eat it now.
Yeah, that quarterback still Jake Mullen.
Guys, I love that. Domino, nice job. Once again, you know, the season that they put on their crust, I want it. I'll put it on anything. I'll put it on a sandwich. I'll put it on anything. What about that? Back to the action. John Lobb, hands it off. Marcus Griffin tries to put up field. Gets caught by the defensive tackle, number 74, Javon Jordan. There, AJ Parrish. there. Richard Sumlin there. Just a whole host of defensive players.
No, not at all.
I agree with you, Karen. I think you know, it's just one of those things they talk about, swarming to the ball. And that's one thing that has been able to do. That's been extremely successful for them, being able to swarm.
Oh, wow. You're all on the same page.
Under center at quarterback. The give is to Griffin behind John Frick at fullback. A big collision there, a big pop by the linebacker, the outside linebacker from South Dakota. He's got his jersey tucked up under his back. Can't really see who that is. Hogan's, Darius Hogan's there on the play. Brought down Marcus Griffin. Rico Wallace will now give the offense their next play. Penalty flag down on the play. It looks like we may have the legal substitution. I missed those. Couldn't find the referee. John Bob takes a shot to the snap, backs up, scrolls out to his right, fires, looking downfield, and it is caught there on the far sideline by number 83, Justin Hem. So Hem is, he's kind of settled into his own. He's had a couple of big plays here. He had that one fumble, but making up for it there. He's certainly having a pretty good second half.
Yeah, we'll check the ball.
Real quick, Eric Galco, tell us about these guys that you know, you think could possibly be showcasing themselves for the NFL today.
Yeah, we'll come back to this slide for right here.
Chris Kordakis motions across, back to the action. We'll go back to that slide throughout the day. Don Lobb fires downfield. Incomplete to Evan Twombly. Solid coverage there.
So unusual for construction. I could see that.
Twombly was looking for some pass interference on that incomplete. He was putting his hands in the air and begging for a pass interference call. Looks like he may have just got it. And again, you know, if you're wondering why the referee was so late, this is a training event for the Big Ten. So you know, we're training not only are we training, we're training referees, but we're training quality referees. And picked by the Big Ten.
Yeah,
back to the action now. John Mobb in there. Marcus Griffin out at wide receiver, so two running backs in here on the play. Ron Allen Jr. in the backfield. Marcus Griffin now playing wide receiver, so he doesn't really know the motions or anything like that, but he does know his route. And doesn't even know the route. Pitch out to Ron Allen Jr. Cuts up field. Got some room to run. A little shake and bake out past the 30-yard line. Down to the 28. And a first down. Let's revisit this list here, Mr. Eric Galco, of guys that you think could possibly be going to the NFL.
Yeah, I think Lobin.
John Lobb stands defense from the gun. Chris Kordak is at the bottom. Larry Lowe, John Frick, two Shepherd guys up there at the top. Looking right, throws for John Frick. Complete, and then tackled by Joe Narcisse as soon as he catches the ball. But Frick's first catch. Second down and about three, maybe four there. Kind of tough to tell from this angle for the offense. John Lobb under center. Marcus Griffin and Theron Allen Jr. both in the backfield. They give this to Allen Jr. Shake and bake, gets by the defensive end. Keeps running upfield. He just kept his feet turned there and had a great play. Had a great move there to shake off number 95, defensive end Stephen Young. Throws him right there at the line of scrimmage and got past him.
Yeah, that's the whole thing that I can do.
Got my calculations wrong there. 16-yard line going in. Give this to Allen Jr., but he fumbles the ball. Couldn't quite convert the handoff, but it looks like, I think you're right, Kerry. The offense did recover it. Couldn't quite tell who recovered it down there, but it looked like maybe the... Chris Kordakis goes in motion, comes back to his original position on the left side of the field. To give this to Theron Allen Jr. up the middle, shakes and bake, gets a block from Pavelic, tries to get to the outside, but a good stop there by number 18. Again in the backfield, John Lobb under center. Chris Kordakis motions from left to right across the line of scrimmage. Looks back for David Pavelic, overthrown and almost intercepted. But I think the baseball honestly deserves it in that corner. David Pavelic was the only receiver in the area. two guys there on the coverage. Fourth down now coming up for the offense. Hokies trying to make a big lead here. 16-14. But that is only if they can put it in the end zone. We're going to put down here on this play. John Lobb with stands with Ron Alexander in the backfield in the shotgun. Very low in John Frick, Shepherd Products up there up top. Lob has to step up, rolls to his right, throws, intercepted. Almost intercepted for the sixth interception. Would have been a big play as Lob was looking to get it to Larry. To your little board here, Mr. Eric Galco, and you know, kind of touch on a few more.